Hello, we're back. Prior to and leading up to the expansion here at Matan, we teamed up with our longtime friends and partners at CNC Fiberglass Components. Due to the initial layup of our parts that you've been seeing throughout this episode, the DePonte family are longtime friends of mine. In fact, it's hard for me even to use the word friends, that for over 25 years, they've treated me like family.
That's right.
Yeah, he can handle it.
Joe, known to most as Senior, has been my longest mentor in the business.
My longtime mentor, Joe DePonte. That's his son, Caesar, with back of his head to us. Known that dude since he's been 15 years old, man. These are some of the greatest people in the business.
Along with his brother, Craig, in turn, have become mentors to my son, who have watched both those young men not just help their dad out, but in fact run multiple divisions of CNC on their own, ensuring when they finally do drag Senior out of that plant to retire, I'll guarantee you that the DePonte family's legacy in the industry will continue for many more decades. Besides providing us the use of their plant, they have also manufactured all of our production molds. There's no truer words for me to say than if it wasn't for the DePonte family, I'm not sure there would have been a Matan Classic Collection. And oh my God, I can't believe I didn't mention Joe's wife, Mama Rosa. Forget Classic Collections. If it wasn't for Mama Rosa, none of us would be here. She keeps it all together for all of us. So thank you, Mama. Here's your shout out. Okay, back to the builds. As I mentioned earlier with semi-custom boat building, once the part comes out of the mold, that's when we begin the customization. And that's where we leave CNC. Whether the boats are 13s, 21s, 32s, after the parts are made, we stack them up, put them on a trailer, and transport them up to Matan to build the boats. We did that with the 21s, moved two sets of parts into the shop, separated them, and began the stringer fabrication. The stringer grid system to each of the 21s needs to accommodate different above-deck configurations, such as the seating. The Special Edition has a traditional RPS helm seat, and the Sportfish has a leaning post with baitwell. Two very different seating options, which means two very different mounting locations. Then you throw in a T-top. I think you get it. The bottom line is, each one of these stringer systems needs to be customized. Bonding and fastening these components to the stringer system, we needed to fabricate composite mounting pads. Constructed out of two composite materials, Penske board and G10. Penske board is a dense, rigid composite used to substitute wood. G10 is a solid, extremely strong composite that is very similar to an alloy, where you can drill, tap, thread a machine screw so it can act like a nut on the other side of the deck. We combined the two together to eliminate an issue that we found, and I'll say it, in just about every boat we've ever restored, and even in newer boats that we've taken apart during insurance repairs, and that is the intrusion of water. Over the years, the water will actually work its way down the thread of the fastener, one drip at a time, into the core or the bowels of the boat. Accelerating the rot to the wood, or in foam-filled boats, the foam becomes like the inside of a watermelon, absorbing years and years of those many drips. To eliminate that from ever happening, we backed the G10 composite with an inch and a half piece of Penske board.
You notice it's quarter inch G10 with a piece of one inch Penske. We do that so we can drill through the other side, tap into our G10, However, we'll just go into our Penske board maybe about a half an inch, because we're going to have to go into the Penske board drilling in from the other side and using a tap. The advantage of this is over time, if the sealant fails in 20 years, there's no way that water could ever infiltrate the inside of the hull.
When our boats leave here, we suggest a maintenance program where every 5 to 10 years, these components should be removed and re-bedded in new sealant. You should do this on all boats, no matter the construction, that there's no sealant that we've found that lasts a lifetime. We fabricated the pads and further put large pieces of Penske board up inside our stringers where we knew we'd be drilling through the stringer.
The G10 backing plates are glued in.
Just have the boats all ready for these guys to come in and just start glassing, because it's going to be a marathon. So what they're doing now is they're doing fillets, where they're skimming everything prior to glassing.
We then gave the inner hull surfaces and the stringers a grinding and sanding, preparing the surfaces for both foam injection and coating application.
Dennis is applying an epoxy-based bilge coating system.
Which leads me to a question that I often get from people comparing our classic collections to the other classic vessels. And that is, hey Mike, are your boats unsinkable? Well, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret about boat building. Every boat 21 feet and under needs to have positive flotation. In other words, any boat 21 feet and under can't sink by Coast Guard regulations. This is accomplished with flotation foam. Adding enough flotation foam to surpass the buoyancy of the overall weight of the vessel, including the weight of the occupants. At the time of these builds, we didn't have our fancy foam injection machine we now have. We needed to foam the hulls the old-fashioned way by mixing up batches of flotation foam and pouring them in the cavities we need to fill. However, throwing a little twist into it by covering the cavities with vacuum bag film. So when the flotation foam expands, it hits the bag with resistance, compressing the cells of the foam denser rather than letting it expand to the surrounding areas. This enhances the overall buoyancy of the foam. We then cut the foam down, longboarded, and sanded the foam to the surrounding height of the stringers. Then laminate in multiple layers of fiberglass mat.
That's the inside hull. We're giving it the final fit. And gluing the boats together.
And we're gonna leave you here because you know what? We're out of time. So join us on the next episode when we get into the fabrication to the deck liners and the gunnel caps on the Pelham Bay's road to building a Matan. I'm Mike Borelli. Thank you for joining us. See you next time on Making It Matan.
If you like this segment, click right here. If you like this segment and you want to watch the whole episode, click right here.